This module is actually going to be on resorption. And now before you check and look at that again, yes, you're going to be having a prosthodontist talk to you about resorptive lesions. But there's actually a rationale for that. If you think about it, most resorptive lesions are actually first seen and diagnosed by the restorative dentist. But then it's referred to the endodontist, the specialist, for treatment. And so with that in mind, the restorative dentists actually need to understand a little bit about resorption to be able to have conversations with the patient. So I have a few learning objectives for us. My goal is to be able to help you identify some of the different types of resorption that you're going to see. And although it's not something that you see on a day-to-day basis, again, they will come into your practice and you might see a few of them a month or every few months. We also then need to discuss the treatment options and the treatment prognosis. Again, I don't need to discuss with patients exactly what's going to be done or needed to be done, but I need to have a rationale as to what I know and what I think might happen. And in a sense, what we're trying to do is facilitate a discussion for the non-endodontists in the group to allow a common thought process when we start seeing some of these lesions. Now, if your group actually is fortunate enough to have an endodontist in it, you're going to be able to get much more information than I'm going to give you, because the endodontist will be able to speak at this from a pure treatment standpoint as well, of which I'm going to be talking in generalizations.